Over the course of more than 130 years, Belmont University has undergone remarkable growth and transformation, evolving from its modest beginnings into a top-ranking institution. The Lila D. Bunch Library, an integral part of this institution, plays a pivotal role in advancing the university's mission and enabling student success. The library owns several Crowley scanners, but most recently purchased a Zeutschel OS C. Today, we're honored to speak with Molly Randolph, Special Collections Manager at Belmont University, about the library's digitization program, collections, and how the OSC is influencing their goal to provide digital resources for their students. Well, hi, Molly. It's so great to have you here with us today. So we're going to ask you a couple of questions. So we know that Belmont University has like a fascinating story. I mean, it's been around for 130 years. So if you can just give us like a little bit of background about the history of Belmont and Lila D. Bunch Library.
Yeah, sure. So Belmont University started off as Belmont College for Young Women in 1890. It was actually founded by two school teachers from Philadelphia who came down to Nashville and thought it would be a great place to start a girls' school. So there were a couple of iterations of the school after that original founding, but girls' school until 1951, and then we became a co-ed institution under the name of Belmont College, and we were associated with the Tennessee Baptist Convention. And we were a Baptist-affiliated school until 2008. We became a university in 1992. And now we have almost 9,000 students.
That's amazing. And then just kind of like let everyone know like your role with the university and the library and then maybe some of the collections that you help with.
Sure, sure. So my name is Molly Randolph. I'm the head of special collections here at Belmont. So I'm in charge of the archives. I also run two galleries on campus as well, the Gallery of Iconic Guitars and the Hart, Frederick Hart Studio Museum, which means I have a very diverse collection. I have a lot of, university history. So that would involve, books and scrapbooks, uniforms, everything you'd think of dealing with university history. And then I also have 3D objects, with the two galleries I run as well. So, it's a really nice, diverse collection. I'm the only one in my department, so that means that I definitely have a backlog of things to scan.
I'm sure you do.
I've got a lot. But we're really excited that we have our scanner now, so it's making everything go faster.
Very nice. And then of your collections, what seems to be like more of the priority for you all, like as far as your goals, like what would you hope to scan first as the main priority and then maybe down in the future?
Sure.
Just out of curiosity.
So we just completed a big project that I got grant funded to scan our historic scrapbook collection. That was a pretty high priority because they were just great primary resources and they were falling apart. And so I really didn't feel comfortable having researchers access them when, the pages are literally crumbling. So those are all scanned now, which is amazing. And then my next priority, I think, is going to be scanning our yearbooks. We have 1951 and earlier scanned. No one has done until 1997 is when we stopped doing physical yearbooks. So those aren't done at all. So those will probably be the next major scanning project I turn to. Those are really, they're requested a ton, especially since a lot of our alumni are in them. So that's another high priority project.
Wow, that's incredible. I'm glad you're able to scan some of more of the ones that are kind of falling apart before they really fall apart.
Yes.
So that's awesome. And then I know you end up purchasing the Zeutschel OS C. So how has that been very helpful for you all? Like, is there any benefits that really has gained a lot of interest or has really helped with the scanned materials that you're currently scanning? Some like maybe more of the 3D objects or the yearbooks as well?
Other than like books, I haven't really, most everything I've scanned has been pretty flat.
Okay.
But it's been a dream, really, to work with. Really, you can do anything in it you want. So it's made the scanning process really easy and fast. I also like that it saves as you go, so you don't have to worry, like, you know, you scan 10 pages and it crashes or something. That doesn't happen with this one. But I think my largest scanning project had 750 individual scans, and it was able to do it all in one go, process all of the information. I didn't have to worry about losing anything. Because that's, you know, it's such a horror if you're halfway through and then something happens. So it's just made processing it really fast. I like that as I'm scanning, I can edit individual images so I can straighten them or change the focus. There's a lot more bells and whistles I haven't even gotten into yet, but I can crop it. So it's like those fundamental core things, I can do them as I'm scanning. So I don't have to go back in later. It just kind of creates a finished product immediately.
Very cool. So it sounds like it's very user-friendly. It makes things really fast for you to scan things, where, like you said, you don't have to change the settings too much, which is great. So do you have the scanner in a separate room in the library, or do you have it like more in an open area?
Yeah, so basically that. It is up here in Special Collections. So I have like a reading room with like tables and bookshelves, and that's where the scanner lives. There are a couple of us that went through the training when it was first set up, so it's not just me that knows how to use it. So if someone wants to use the scanner, they can make an appointment with me, they can show up, or they can call the library kind of front desk area. So like I had a researcher who wanted to scan a diary that his mother had. And I clicked the button that I'd already set up. I kind of gave him 2 minutes of tutorial, and then he scanned all 200 pages himself. And I was here if he had any questions, but he was able to, you know, do it great on his own.
Oh, wow. That's incredible.
Yeah.
Perfect. And then as far, you did mention some training. So is that training that the Crowley Company actually provided, or is that just training you guys did on your own?
No, that was training the Crowley Company provided. So they had a technician come to the library, to the reading room, and set the machine up. And thank goodness. And then he worked with any staff that was interested, and we had a full day of training. And I've had questions since, and I'm able to just call him and ask questions, and it's been really helpful. And we realized we didn't have enough memory, and he was able to help us kind of figure out what to get on our machine to kind of increase our storage capacity. So he's been a resource. So yeah, the training was great. Training was really great. Perfect. It's not like you just get a booklet
and you have to go on your way. So I know the Zeutschel OSC actually has the OCR capability. Do you guys utilize that, or has that been beneficial for patrons when they scan the materials, or from other collections that you all scan in-house?
Yes. So I'm so glad we got that. I've been impressed. You know, in scrapbooks, the material is sometimes sideways or upside down, and it still caught those things if they're printed out. So it's been the OCR capabilities. And the software has been really great.
So I know you scanned a lot of yearbooks, and you do have like a digital repository to probably hold all these materials. Can you talk, maybe share a little bit about that?
Sure. So Belmont's digital repository is just kind of our big place online where we can put anything we scan. We kind of have it broken up by schools. I now have my own special collections section on the website. So if you do want to go look at my scrapbooks, it's repository.belmont.edu, and then it would be under, you know, special collections. But it's been really great to be able to have everything that I've scanned scrapbook wise on one area, and anyone can access it. So it's not just our students and staff and faculty, it's also the general public, which kind of goes into that educational mission of making these things available for anybody. If you do go on and look at the scrapbooks, you'll see that I've been able to scan them so that they turn like books. So it's like you're turning the pages of a book. And that was really easy to do with the scanner. So I'd scan the individual pages and then I just put them into a site called Issue and it just joined them together seamlessly. So it was a really easy process. You know, you just have to scan everything. But yeah, the digital repository has been a great place to showcase our digital collections.
Is there anything in particular that you have recently maybe scanned or really excited about scanning in the near future that you like to showcase or tell us about?
Well, we have, I mean, there's so many great things in my collection. We have a ledger book from the early school that I'm really excited to scan. It has, you know, receipts from a lot of local businesses. So I think it'll be great, not just for Belmont's history, but also Nashville in general. So I'm really excited about that one. And we only have one.
Extra special.
So yeah, it's definitely really special. So that's something that I'm planning on getting out there.
Thank you so much, Molly, and have a great day.
Thank you. I really appreciate it. Thanks, Amanda.